Told her, don't wait for me, your time is up, better save it, please. I just ran up me an 80 piece. You wanna do something deep like you're prepping me. Dogging that bitch till her face full of Maybelline. In my cup, maybe it's lit, we don't do no blue. Yeah, first on Billie Jean, Billie Jean, Billie Jean. Drop the heat popping, no signs of him stopping. He need all his profits, I'm saying he cocky. I know that he got it, he flew a bitch out from the trap. It's exotic, I'm smoking Supreme, had the boxy. 458, bro, I take off like rockets. White body, kick like Buffy the body.
I'm gonna make back on the name, it's got it too hot in my neck.
Let the homie go handle it. Be pointing stones on my neck like they run like a
Alright guys, we're coming back today with the 2020 Air Raid that everybody is saying is the OG. That is completely false. Let's get into it real quick. Hope the sun is not making a crazy looking shadow on it, but it kind of seems like it does, but I don't know. Let's get into it real quick. This is the 2007. Like I said, this is the 2013. So we have the one in the 2020 in the middle. You can see differences straight up. This is just like the OG pair, which this is the first time it retroed. Automatically off the top, we see the leather right here is gray. The leather on the 2020 pair is black. And the leather on here is dark gray. And this is dark gray also. And the strap is dark gray. Now the leather strap is a little bit darker from the OG. So we see the difference automatically. We know that's not, this is not an OG Air Raid. And they're not trying to say it's an OG Air Raid. All the news outlets out there are saying that it's an OG Air Raid. But that is not what Nike is saying. They're just saying it's an Air Raid. Let's see another huge difference off the top. The tongue is leather on the first retro of the Air Raid. It's leather on the 1992 Air Raid. And once again, this is gray on the 1992 Air Raid also, the original. Oh, let's get back to this one. The 2013 is also leather, okay? But here we have it here. This 2020 pair is suede. it's a new buck. It's not even suede, it's a new buck. On the tongue, so we see automatically that this is not the OG, and they're trying not to even make it the OG. Y'all called it the OG. It is not the OG. Also, this is 3M right here. The Air Raid is 3M, and it's a darker gray. This is, well, actually, this gray and this gray is about the same gray, a little shade darker, but it's about the same. Not bad there. On the back is the huge difference. This is crazy. Okay, so this is the 2013. See how, let me zoom in. See how you can't really tell the words, but you can kind of see them, but the lines, see those like pod lines right here? They're a little bit defined. Let's check out how good the first retro, first time in retro. See how the lines are really good on here. You can see it says for outdoor use only. The wording is very good. Everything is spot on. Check this out. Now this is suede. This is suede and this is freaking nubuck. Bruh, you can't even see the wording on this shoe. It's that crazy. You can't even see it. You can't even see it. Like, you could barely see it, bro. Like, that's the 2013 compared to the 2020. Now look at the 2020 compared to the OG. Bruh, you can't even hardly even see it. Look how Nike skips on quality though. That's exactly what I've been talking about for years. The times Nike just absolutely just skips on the quality. This pair was absolutely done good. This pair was okay. But this pair is just, it's so disappointing. I don't want, this is not the First, last night I was in a group chat and we was talking. I was saying this is the worst time this shoe has ever been retro. This is the worst Nike retro ever. But guess what? It's technically not, because they didn't intend this to be the OG Air Raid. They just keep sneaking off little bitty hints to make you think it's the OG Air Raid, but they never said it was the OG remake of the Airhead Air Raid. They just called it the Airheads. You might as well call them Nike Airheads. But I mean, I don't know, guys. When you're buying the shoes, just don't think that you're gonna get that that release. You're not going to. And also with this bag too, I don't know why they did this. This peeled in, but for some odd reason they keep making it come out like a Batman signal or something, bro. I don't know why they doing this. They did it to this one too, but anyway, guys, if you buy them, don't be expecting. This is for No Limit War. He asked me to get him a pair. This is his pair right here. I won't be buying this pair. I'll skip because I still have this pair that looks darn near DS. So, and I still have this pair that I wear too. So, anyway, I'm not going to crap on the shoe too bad, because now I know it's not the OG. It's just another Air Raid. Man, I'm looking at these joints for the first time, and I'm thinking, because I'm about to get rid of them. Off the top, off the rip, they pretty fire to me, man. I like them. I don't even like 13s like that. I think that green is gonna fade in on that white. But I hate this little, I hate this cheap whatever they put on here. It just fades off, and eventually, if you rub it, you're gonna see the dark print behind it. I hate when they use whatever that type of nappy head suede, bro. Besides that, look at this, bro. The fake carbon fiber, bro. Is this real? This is actually real carbon fiber right here. But this is, it might be real too. I don't know. Nah, this look like this shit. I don't know if none of this stuff real. Look like it's all fake. Might be all fake carbon fiber. I don't even know what they do with Jordans anymore. With these 13s. I had every single 13 in high school, so I didn't really want any more 13s. But just looking at them, you got the, of course, the holographic thing on the side, man, which I like the best about the 13s, but I don't know why everybody dogging these 13s. I actually think they're pretty cool. I think they're pretty cool, and I don't even like 13s like that. I'm not a 13 fan, but I actually like them. So I would say if you could get them for retail, hop on it, man, because these things are going to be cool. Just think about, if you're going somewhere, you want to feel lucky, you put on your lucky 13s, man. Can't get much cooler than that, guess. What's up, YouTube? This your boy Ronji, and I'm coming back with another video, and I hope I could just throw across my small amount of common sense on comparing leathers. I apologize for the setup right now, but it's dark outside, and I just bought this shattered backboard shoe, and I was actually with my friend when he got these Foot Locker manager, I won't say what state where, but he actually backdoored these size 12 to him, and he didn't have a second size 12. He only had one, and he had an 11 and a half, and he only paid $300 to get them backdoored in 2015. Crazy thing about it is the 11 and a half he offered me for the same price, and I said no. Yeah, crazy, right? But I'm just not a fan of ones like that. I do like the Chicago ones. I have the original from 1985, and I cannot wait until they come back out with their shoe, because that shoe is hands down the best one, and I love the shoe. It's definitely, everything about the Chicago one is amazing. But what this shoe gets the most attention about is the fact that people talk about the leather quality, and I get it, okay? Coming from a lot of bad Jordans, this is considered to be an amazing leather shoe. So we're gonna get into that. And I'm gonna just tell you off the top, this cut of leather is not bad at all. You see the thickness of that cut of leather on there? It's not bad at all. For someone who does not buy Jordan 1s like that, out of 600 and something shoes, now I had this today, it'll be gone tomorrow, but I have this Jordan 1, I have the one that just released Saturday, I forgot the name of that one, and I also have the Chicago, right? The rest I don't have. All the Spider-Mans, I sold for retail back in the days to my friends. Yeah, like idiots, no, like friends. But this pair I just picked up from a guy, and I'm just looking at how thin the leather is compared to the shattered backboard. See how thin that is? And people talk about the plushness. Now, this is not leather, so I can't compare this, but I'm doing my best, fellas. But look at the thickness on the back. It's a pretty decent leather on the back of this shoe, okay? The thing about it is, when you see this gridded up like this, this is a sign of real leather. It's crazy because the thickness of the back of this shoe is not equivalent to the thickness of the back of this shoe. So in reality, this Jordan 1, what was this called? The Guavas. This Guava leather on the back is actually better than this shoe. The thickness of leather is a good telltale sign of quality. But I will be honest with you. The thickness of leather on this portion is one of the best I've seen. And not only that, I will say on the Air Jordan, this feeling is definitely leather, okay? It's not the leather like what's found on the Saint Laurents. It's a whole different leather. This is lambskin, and I keep forgetting the other skin. But this is two different skins because this is the metallic version. Of course, y'all like to compare leathers, but this shoe costs like $1,000. This shoe was only like, what was the price? The price thing came off. I'm sure this shoe was like 160 or something, 140, I don't know, 140 maybe. But you cannot compare quality when it comes down to this shoe to that. But I will tell you, this is a real leather, and there's nothing squishy plush about this leather, okay? Just because the leather is squishy doesn't make it a real plush leather. And I will tell you, this leather is more close to the Air Jordan 9 leather, okay? The Air Jordan 9 stiff leather that y'all say is all stiff and cheap. No, leather is thick. It's like skin when they put it together. See how thickness that, see the thickness of the leather? That's a good tell sign of it being a good leather also. Okay, and see how it's about to bead up and everything just like this? It's a stickler of it being a good leather. So I get it when people say that this shattered backboard Air Jordan 1 is a real good leather. Look how good my boy left his shoes. He still got, you can't see the tag. He still has the size 12 tag. Look, bro, my guy's in, his brother's an NBA player, gets him a lot of shoes. But back then, me and the guy in college, he gave me the OG 11, what you call them, the blue ones, the light blue ones, the North Carolinas, and he gave me the white and red ones, and he gave me the Concords from like 2001. Dude used to hook me up back in the days, man. And so I got a lot of cool things. The way I give shoes is what I got from him, man. But anyway, that story to the side. The leather on this, now this is the same shoe that Uma Thurman wore up in Kill Bill, and also Bruce Lee kind of used to wear back then. It's very similar to it, okay? It's a Thai cheese. The leather on this shoe is so good. Like, when I say it's so good, it is so good that it's unbelievable. I wish I had another pair, but I don't. I need to see if I can find another pair. But the leather on this is a very plush type of leather, okay? It's plush, and you can tell it's real leather. This leather and this leather is the same feeling. It's crazy. I never thought I would find another shoe that had the same feeling as this leather. And I will admit, it's definitely on this shattered backboard shoe. So with that said, this has got to be real leather on this shattered backboard shoe. I think a guy did a video where he cut them open and saw. But I would honestly say, without a shadow of a doubt, this is the best leather Air Jordan 1 shoe I have ever seen all around. Okay? I cannot lie about that. But when y'all talk about leathers, it's similar to this, but it's nowhere to this. And of course, we all know why, because this is a luxury Saint Laurent shoe. But I keep telling you guys, it's hard to compare those type shoes to luxury shoes. I try to stay away from that, but in this video, I kind of just wanted to point to y'all. It's a better leather shoe than the other Air Jordans, but it's not an amazing leather. Do you see the difference? It's a better leather, for the most part, than this whole shoe, even though the back of this thickness is pretty good. But it's better all the way around leather shoe than this Guava. If anybody wants that Guava, by the way, I sell it for like 110 ship. I think it's been worn once, but whatever. Looks DS. But it's better than that, but it's not a great leather like this. So, guys, with that said, this is actually my first time actually having them. Because I don't know if I've ever owned the Shattered Backboards. I can't even think, but With that said, guys, understand what I'm doing from this video. I'm not trying to dog the shoe because it's actually a really good shoe. And if I didn't get them for so low, I wouldn't be letting them go, guys. I got them for $700. 100% authentic. You could judge from yourself. They are 100% authentic. I was with him when he got them from the Foot Locker. But just because I got them for $700 means that I have to hook them up to my friend who is a Air Jordan 1 fan and who has been searching for this shoe for a long time, and he wears a size 12. So I got them for $700. He gets them for $700. That's how we do in this game. If you want to make friends in this game, make friends, guys, and it'll take you a long way. Anyway, this your boy Ron G coming back with a weird video that it's... I'm sitting on a chair, and it's just, it's everywhere. Anyway, peace.